Dear students, in the previous video, we saw some of the protocols when you leave your home. Okay, but you have to follow some more protocols when you are coming from outside to your home also. Okay, see the first point. When you come home, try not to touch anything. Second one, remove your shoes. Third one, disinfect your pet's paws if you took them for walk. Fourth one is remove your clothes and place them in a bag to be washed. Fifth one, leave your bag, purse, wallets, keys, etc. in box that at the entry of your home. Sixth one, have a shower if you can't wash all the exposed areas. Seventh one, wash your mobile phone and glasses with hot soapy water or alcohol. Okay, next one is clean with bleach all the surfaces of whatever bought from outside before storing it. Ninth one, carefully remove and dispose of your gloves, that then wash your hands. Remember, it is not possible to carry out complete disinfection. The goal is to minimize the risk. Okay, children? Dear students, hope you all are staying safe and staying home. Okay, so already we have completed our two sessions of chapter 1, where to look from. So this is the third session. So just we will have a quick revision of all the things which we have learned already. So what we have learned first, we have learned about different objects and its different views. Even though the objects are same, its views will be different. So the shape of the picture is getting differed. Okay, the way you view the object is different. Okay, so the three views we saw about, one is front view, top view and side view. Okay, and we did some exercises and hope you would have completed your homeworks also. Okay, next one, what we saw some of the patterns in Rangoli. For using the dotted grids, we also made some of the patterns and we also were drawing some of the patterns using straight lines and curved lines. And you have drawn some of the shapes also and some of the objects also. Hope you have remembered and hope you have done your homeworks also. Next, what we saw? So we saw a story, okay, and we saw a painter's trick also. You should have remembered the concept which we learned through the stories about mirror halves, and we have drawn some of the objects. We have completed some of the objects to its mirror halves, and we have found out it's not possible for all the objects just to follow the same trick. Only for the objects which look similar in both the halves can we use this trick. Okay, and we have drawn, and you have drawn, I hope you have drawn the sum of the objects which cannot be divided into two similar halves also. And we have drawn some of the, we have seen some of the shapes and found out that it has been divided into two similar halves or not. Okay, and you have drawn some of the examples also. And we have saw some of the objects and we have divided it into two similar halves. We have divided those pictures, only those pictures which can be divided into two similar halves. Okay, so next what we saw. Next we are going to see the new concept, that is English capital letters and its mirror halves. Okay, so let's go to the concept now. Okay, I'll show you some of the alphabets and its mirror halves. Okay, first. So, what is this alphabet? It is A. So, how can it be divided into similar halves? So, it can be divided, if you fold the alphabet this way, it can be divided into two similar halves. How it has been divided? It has been divided vertically. Okay, so we call this as vertical line of symmetry. So there are figures which can be divided into two similar halves. They are called symmetrical figures. Okay, so we have divided A in way vertically. Okay, so we have vertical line of symmetry. Next we see the next alphabet, B. So how it can be divided into two similar halves? It can be divided horizontally. Okay children, so we have horizontal line of symmetry in alphabet B. Okay, so the A and B both are mirror halves. Next, C. C is also be divided into two similar halves, but horizontally, only horizontally. It cannot be divided into two similar halves vertically. Okay, next comes D. D can also be divided into two similar halves horizontally. Next one, E. E can also be divided into two similar halves horizontally. Next, F. Can we divide this into two similar halves? Just see, it is not similar. Even vertically and also horizontally, it won't look similar. So, F is not symmetrical or F is not a mirror half. Then comes alphabet G. G also cannot be divided into two similar halves, both vertically and horizontally. Okay, children? Next comes H. H can be divided into two similar halves. How it can be divided? Both vertically and also horizontally. Okay. Next comes I. I can also be divided both horizontally and vertically. Okay, children? Okay. Next comes J. J cannot be divided into two similar halves. Next, K. K can be divided into two similar halves, but only horizontally. L. L cannot be divided into two similar halves. But M can be divided into two similar halves, but only vertically. Now see N. You may get doubt in this alphabet N, but it cannot be divided into two similar halves. If you see, it is opposite. So, it is not symmetrical. Okay. Next comes O. O can be divided into two similar halves, both horizontally and also vertically. Next comes P. E cannot be divided into two similar halves. Q also cannot be divided into two similar halves. R cannot be divided into two similar halves. S also cannot be divided into two similar halves. But you may get slight doubt in seeing S, but it is looking opposite. So it cannot be divided into two similar halves. Next comes T. Can it be divided into two similar halves? Yes, it can be divided vertically. U can also be divided, but only vertically. V can also be divided into two similar halves, but only vertically. W can also be divided into two similar halves, just like M. M is the opposite of W. Yes, children? Now, X. X can also be divided, but both vertically and also horizontally and vertically. Y can also be divided into two similar halves, but only vertically. Now comes Z. Z cannot be divided into two similar halves. If you fold, it will look opposite. Okay, children? Okay. Now, let's see all the letters together. Okay. So, A has A has vertical line of symmetry. B, C, D and E has horizontal line of symmetry. F and G doesn't have any line of symmetry. H and I has both horizontal and vertical line of symmetry. J, K, L doesn't have any line of symmetry. M has one vertical line of symmetry. N has no line of symmetry. O has both vertical and horizontal line of symmetry. P, Q, R and S doesn't have any line of symmetry. T, U, V, W has vertical line of symmetry. X has both vertical and horizontal line of symmetry. Y has vertical line of symmetry. Z doesn't have any line of symmetry. Hope you are clear with it. Let's go back to the chapter now. So now see this. Can you guess these letters from their halves? So now can you guess these letters from their halves? What is the first letter? Let's see. Hope you are clear. What is the first letter? It is A. Okay, children. Next one. What is the next one? It should be similar half. Okay. So only those letters which can be divided into halves have been given over here. Okay. You have to find the other half and complete the picture here. Second one is what? It is C. Okay. So, what is the next one? It is H. What is the next one? It is U. It is not J. It is U. What will be the next one? It will be B. Next one is not K. It is X. Because only which can be divided into similar halves are given over here. Okay.
So using such letters, we can also make words which have similar halves. Okay, children, so guess the words by looking at their halves. So now see the first one word. It is H-O-W. Here also W-A-X. Here it comes C-O-O-K. E, D, this is what? Rice, R, I, C, E. So, what is this actual word? The word is, the sentence is, how wax cooked rice. Okay, children, hope you are clear with this.
Next, we are going to see how to make a mask using the mirror halves. Okay, so here we are going to take a sheet of paper and we are going to fold it and draw only one side of the picture, and we are going to cut it along and trace the other side of the picture and going to make a mask. Okay, I'll just show you an example over here. Take a sheet of paper, it can be a rectangular shape of a paper, fold it along and draw one half of the picture. Okay, and cut it along the edges, and your picture and your sheet will look like this. Now unfold it. Okay, so you can see the shape of mirror half. You have to draw and complete the other half and use the rubber band, color it and make a mask and enjoy. Okay, children, hope you have enjoyed this chapter. Okay, so let's see in the next class. The next class we will see the next chapter. Okay, children, thank you.